So you join me once again in Times Square early in the morning. It's currently 8:30. We've just had some breakfast, sat down, ate it in the beautiful Times Square, and I think now we are going to try and go up the Empire State Building before it gets too busy. And then we have to queue for 2 hours like we did last time. But I look like this.
Observatorios del Empire State Building son los más altos de la ciudad de Nueva York y ofrecen vistas panorámicas de 300...
So after a very short lift ride, we are at the 80th floor of the Empire State Building, and we are about to go up to the main observation deck, which is on the 86th floor. And the reason why we've got out at the 80th is because lifts in the 1930s, in this case 1931, did not go as far as the 86th floor. I mean, there is a 102nd floor in this building, which is as tall as the New World Trade Center's observation deck. It is a mad building and a gorgeous building at that. So we've made it to the 86th floor even, the view is of course amazing. Now last time we came it was night time, but this time it is daytime. It is currently 9:30 in the morning and it is glorious. So we've come down to South Ferry because we are actually thinking of catching the Staten Island Ferry to Staten Island, because why not? It's a free ship journey thing. It might be good. It might be good. So, let's go. So we've got off the ferry and we've decided it's like just the right temperature for sitting in Battery Park. So that's what we've done. We've sat down on some weird wacky chair and we're just going to chill in Battery Park for a bit, try and log on to the free Wi-Fi which is provided I think throughout this park. So that's what we're going to do for a bit. Staten Island Ferry, great views, took a while. Staten Island, don't go there if you're at all, well do go there, just don't stay there for too long. met a lovely woman though on the train, and she talks a lot about just New York in general and what it's like to live here.
I believe that if we are honest with ourselves, that the most fascinating problem in the world is who am I? What do you mean? What do you feel when you say the word I? I myself.
Now there's a reason why I am not going to be so energetic as I usually am in this location, and that is because I'm currently at the World Trade Center with my colleague. It's given me goosebumps, this place, because like 2,000 people died here the year before I was born, and on the day of 9/11, my mom had her first scan. You know, like when you're pregnant, you have a scan. For me, so that was like the first time anyone ever saw me as like a fetus. So it's quite a prominent place, really, because it's just the sheer scale of the buildings that were once here. Like this, each one is one square acre or 1 acre, and the pools are massive. They are just unbelievable. Like I'm currently stood at one. It does, honestly, it gives you goosebumps and it sends shivers around your spine. Now, we came here before when I was 13, and it still hits you. The names on the piece of metal, they still hit you, and it's so sad. Like, we're currently at the South Tower, the North Tower's over there. It really is an unbelievable place. I can't convey it in a video. You've got to come in, really, to truly see what this place is like. It is actually starting to go quite dark now, and we're still at the World Trade Center. We just went in a bar for a bit, and I've taken some photography, well, I've taken some pictures of the current World Trade Center, and it is gorgeous. Like, it just looks so good. I just ducked under a thing. Like, that's it. It's amazing. We're back in the memorial area, so, you know, it's gonna, yeah, it looks even better at night. I didn't think that was possible, but this area just looks so pretty and it's just so amazing. Just about to leave the World Trade Center to go back to our hotel, and this is the transportation hub. It's unbelievable. I've never seen anything like that in my life. It's unbelievable. Trains are air-conditioned, they've got plastic seats. best of all, they've got